Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're in Southwest Washington, first going after November kokanee on Merwin Reservoir. And then we're heading to Silver Lake to do some crappie fishing. Now if you'd like to learn how to catch fish like this, then stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolff, and this is Angler West Television. For any lake, that's a great bunch of kokanee, but for Merwin Reservoir, they might seem a little small. But it is November. Today, we're on Southwest Washington's Merwin Reservoir for some extremely late fall kokanee, with Jason Upson and Sean Child, who are fishing with Cameron Black of Gone Catching Guide Service.
Well, it's November, and we're up here at Merwin Reservoir. We've been out a few times so far this year. Just kind of in between the fall Chinook and the winter steelhead run, seeing what's going on, and we've actually had some pretty good success catching some nice-sized kokanee, especially for this time of year, some of the largest that I've ever really seen, and fishing's been pretty good. So we got a little bit of east wind blowing, so we're going to try to head to the top part of the lake and get out of the wind, and it's where we've been catching a few fish anyway, so hopefully we'll be in for some good fishing. Let's get your rods out first. Gotta get the killers out.
I've got this like hoochie. Hoochie with some like orange beads in the middle to add some color, and some corn with some tuna on it. And then I got copper dodger from and some pink line right there from Shasta Tackle. And with 10-pound test monofilament. And this is about 6 or 8 inches long, so it gives it a good kick.
As you can see, we're using a fairly short leader from our sling blade there. And one thing that kind of threw us for a loop a little bit this morning was we came out fishing and we only had one of the rods with a real aggressive action on the sling blade. And that's what they wanted. So we had to kind of readjust a few of our other rods, and now they all seem to be fishing pretty well. But I'm guessing just with the temperatures kind of cooling off and with you know, the lake kind of turning back over and mixing and stuff, they definitely want a more aggressive presentation, and really getting that hoochie swung around by the back of the sling blade's been helping. So you can even shorten that leader up a little bit more. I wouldn't go any less than like 6 inches, but as you can see with the sling blade, got a real aggressive bend. I'm on the bottom third of that blade, and that's what's making that lure really kick out and darting that lure around. Seems to be what they want. So we're putting it back about, oh, there is a fish right there. He's got one on right now. Go ahead, you can take him up over the top of that.
Oh, double, double, double.
Oh, yeah, there's another one. So it is November, and so a lot of times, you know, you're going to have,
there you go, perfect.
A lot of times you're going to have, you know, 10 to 11 inch fish, but right now, we've been seeing a lot of like 13 to 14 inch fish, which, now he's probably been about he's probably an average sizer here. He's probably a solid 12, but real fat, real healthy fish. Sean's here. He's a little bit on the small side, but you know, if you go up to like the sister lake Yale up north, that would be a great fish for Yale. So he's still probably a solid 12. So with fish being, you know, with fishing being this good now and the size of fish that we have now, I would absolutely imagine that this spring is going to be really good fishing up here. Some years, even in the springtime, we don't even have fish this big to start the season, like 4, 5, 6 years ago. But like I said, this lake in the last few years have really been kicking out some nice fish.
Okay, so what we found is that these fish are really liking it at about our speed, about 1.4 to 1.3, 1.4, 1.5.
Oh, there's a fish. Hey, whoa, wow, that one's right really there. Going good. But like I said, with how aggressive those fish want it, that extra speed really helping those lures whip around, I think, is definitely key. That one was not even down. That one was sitting in the clip on the surface waiting to get another line stacked on it before it goes down. So we're catching fish from about 5 feet probably to about 25 feet.
Well, that's a good fish. That trout?
Is that trout, Sean?
I don't think so. Well, that's not a trout.
Oh, that's just a that's a nice kokanee. Oh, that's a trout. That is a trout. Say that's a monster kokanee. Nice. Got another trout in the box a little earlier. Oh, nice bow. Beautiful. The trouts are digging this setup as well.
Welcome back to Merwin Reservoir in Southwest Washington. I'm Justin Wolff. We have nice weather and great kokanee fishing in late November, and the rainbows are on the bite as well.
Nice. Kind of a bonus, we've been getting quite a few of these nice healthy trout. You know, the springtime, the kokanee are on the bite so strong, I don't think you see as many of them, but for some reason right now, those guys are chomping. We still haven't even got all the rods out yet. So on a standard sling blade, it comes out of the package pretty flat, like there's not a lot of bend, and depending on how aggressive the fish are or how finicky the fish are, it really makes a difference. As I was mentioning before today, we're liking them with a lot of bend, and just that much bend right there on that bottom third really makes a difference, and it is the key today. The way you want to bend those though is find a decent edge you can use your fingers, but you don't want to make the bend all the way through the blade. You kind of want to just kind of kick that last third of the blade out. You know, if you use your finger this way and kind of come around it, or like use the edge of the boat or something, but try to make a pretty sharp bend in that. So this one we caught on the purple foil, but we've got four different color sling blades out and four different colored hoochies, so it's that aggressive action that's being the ticket today. 25. So here's a couple better fish, and you know, if we're catching these now, I mean, I can't wait till, you know, 3-4 months till the spring bite really picks up. So today we've been letting it out maybe 40 to 60 feet behind the downrigger. You know, I think it's because there's not a lot of pressure on the lake right now that that distance from the boat hasn't been affecting it too much. You know, springtime sometimes we're letting them 100, 120 feet back. All depends what they want. Oh, we got one right here. Grab that, Sean. Go ahead, grab that sucker. A better fish or good one. He was playing possum with you, man. So this lake has a very good population of fish. The state actually moved the limit up to 10 fish per person. And there's been some talk that might actually like deplete the numbers of the fish in this lake, but with the 100,000 that Spielei plants and the natural production, I don't see these fish going anywhere anytime soon. Not to mention, too, that they've been getting continually bigger and bigger each year. So there's a ton of fish in this lake. The Spielei hatchery alone plants like 100,000 sockeye in this lake every year. And someone told me that the natural production could, in the creeks and rivers that come into here, could be 2 to 4 times that. So I don't know what is going on with the lake as far as why these fish are getting bigger. I don't know if it's because people are catching more fish and there's just more food available, or if something's changing in the lake, but I think fishing's gonna be good for a long time to come. If you're thinking about buying some kokanee rods, you might wanna consider the Lama Glass kokanee downrigger rods. This classic glass blank is a great all-around rod for downrigger fishing, or even for top line fishing, or even if you're gonna add a little bit of lead. So another advantage with these rods is that they are virtually indestructible. And when I got little kids running around the boat and clients and stuff that don't fish as often, it's a huge bonus.
These late fall cold water kokanee are not only fun to catch, but they're extremely good eating.
That's a nice one there. That's a good one.
But it's important to clean them right away and to keep them cold until you're ready to cook.
So after cleaning a couple fish, all I do here is take the honer, about four swipes through it, and this blade is as good as new. Having a nice sharp blade on these kokanee really makes the job easy, especially when you gotta do a lot of them. You're right though, that knife is wicked sharp now. I do love those things.
Welcome back everyone, and I hope you enjoyed that quick trip to Merwin Reservoir. Now, of course, kokanee are great fish for kids to go after, as are crappie. Now, let's go to Silver Lake and do a little crappie fishing with Cameron Black and his son, Layden, and my daughter, Emeline. Now, being on the water with Layden reminded me of fishing with Emeline years ago when I filmed a little segment on Clear Lake in California for crappie. It went something like this.
In Clear Lake sloughs and other protected areas that hold bait fish, like marinas. The key is to find the balls of bait fish on your locator, then simply cast a crappie jig towards the bait. We're using a 16-ounce pink teeny rounder with a chartreuse grub tail, but just about any type of jig will work. Emmeline's determined to catch her first crappie before her third birthday, and on the second cast, she got her wish. Live worms on a bobber work well also, but if you're going to release the small ones like this fish, it's better to use artificials.
That's your first crappie. That's your first crappie ever. Yeah. You want to hold them? Grab them just like that. Okay, you're going to grab them right by the lip right there, and we'll take the hook out, and then we're going to say bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
Bye, fish.
While pleased to catch her first crappie, Emmeline was not happy with the small size, so she jumped on a trolling motor to find bigger fish. On this day, it was important to work the bait slowly, just off the bottom, where the big fish live.
It's a big one. That's a big one. Okay, bring it. Now you need to turn the handle again. You get him a little bit. Yes. Look at that one, Emmeline. Look at that one. Look at that. That weighs about 2 pounds, maybe 2.5 pounds. That's really big for a crappie. What should we do with them?
I think we have to take them. I think we have to eat
him. You want to eat him? He looks pretty tasty. Okay.
And crappie sure are tasty. Almost as good as a cracker.
Now let's join Emmeline, Layden, and Cameron Black for a day of crappie fishing on Silver Lake. Silver Lake near Longview, Washington is a marshy little lake that's full of bass, perch, and crappie, which makes it a great place to take kids. Today, my daughter Emmeline is fishing with Layden Black and his dad Cameron. It's early fall and the conditions are getting just right for crappie.
We're at Silver Lake today. Got a nice day to take the kids crappie fishing, and we're gonna go see what we can get.
I love standing up there.
So where we're headed here is there's some canals on the east side of the lake. In October and November, the crappie start moving in there just for the different water temperatures, and they concentrate there and they're pretty easy to catch. So we're using the drift boat today just because we got a big aluminum sled, and it's kind of hard to maneuver within all these lily pads and the brush piles and stuff. And the drift boat's got a lot higher sides for the kids and kind of more of a simplistic way of fishing, but a lot more fun sometimes.
Almost there, buddy. I wonder if all these geese hang out after like November 6th.
We're almost gonna start fishing. Daddy's gonna find a place where there's a ton of them, and we're gonna sit and whack on them.
Maybe we need to get a little closer. Oh, you got nibbled there. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? Hold on, this will do it. Come here, Layden. We're gonna put some magic on your lure.
No. Hey, we just cast it in there.
Okay, Layden, ready? Yeah. All right. I need to get a little closer. I get a little closer than that. Oh, but oh no, look, he's already biting it. See the bobber? Oh, Layden, reel fast. He's got it under the water. Keep reeling, kiddo. Oh, he came off. Almost. We'll try again, okay, buddy? Here, want me to cast you out?
I will.
Okay. Oops, close. Boink, boink. Get him, Layden. You got him. Oh, you got him. What do you got?
Oh,
another bird.
Yeah.
Here, swing him this way. Here, bring him to Dad. Yeah. Oh. Good job.
Layden, hey. I got a boy.
Layden.
And I got it.
What do you have? What's this called?
A perch.
That's right. Maybe. There you go.
I showed him the
Hold the rod. Boy. Hold the rod.
I showed him the extra.
Emeline. You're going to get a perch too.
Emeline.
Oh, she's got him. She still has him. Look, Emeline's got a perch too.
Yeah,
there you go.
That one looks familiar.
So the kids just had a double on perch, but you know this is what's in here right now, but we're still trying to find the crappie. So.
Welcome back to Silver Lake. I'm Justin Wolff. We're near the base of Mount St. Helens, looking to load up with a bunch of crappie. But so far, we've only found the perch.
You know, this is what's in here right now, but we're still trying to find the crappie. So, at least it's fun anyways, because we're catching a lot of them. Hold it. Hold your rod and watch it until I tell you to reel. Get ready to reel, though. Get ready. Oh, there goes Emeline. Bonk, bonk. Oh, you got him.
Another perch.
Oh, Layden's gonna get one too. Reel, Layden, reel. Layden, reel fast. Reel fast. He's got one. Reel, kiddo. Keep reeling. Oh, you almost dropped it. This hand up here. There you go. Oh, you got off. Oh.
Okay, I'm back in the water all by myself.
Yep. Here we go. Yikes. Man, Daddy is not doing good here. Nice cast. All right, watch it. That's going to be a fish really fast. You watch. Oh. Oh, crappie, oh, crappie. Oh, there you go. Oh. Okay, so all we're using is a little 1/32 ounce jig. A little chartreuse seems to be the ticket. A little bait and a little Procure crappie panfish magic. All we do is doctor that up. Put it out there on about a 3-foot bobber. Drop, and that right there is ready to go. Oops. How's your apple, Layden? Oh, I got him. Here you go. You got your fruit snack?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a crappie.
Ah.
I don't know if he's a keeper or not, but he's a pretty nice fish. We'll give him a little measure here. See if he can be a time to join the pan fry. So crappie on Silver Lake have to be 9 inches, and I don't think he's gonna be a good one. Well, actually he is, so about 9.5 or so. Nice little measure here, really makes things easy. So he's gonna take a bath in the ice.
Ew.
And that one's got, cool. So.
Come on,
set it. Got him. Oh.
Oh, it's a perch.
Another perch.
I think.
You think? He is. Layden, look at this fish. Oh, here we go.
That's new, dude.
Bluegill.
Check this out. Layden, isn't he pretty? Really yellow on his belly. You want to pet him?
No. He might bite me.
He's got a tiny little mouth. He ain't going to bite you. He's going to kiss you. Want to give him a kiss?
He's too small.
Oh, okay, fine. I'm gonna throw him back in the water, okay?
No, you.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Say bye.
Bye.
There you go.
She's
That's a good crappie there, Emeline. I think that one's going to go home. Good fish. Yeah. Got a keeper.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. He's good. Yeah, he's a good crappie there. He gets to go home. Gotta throw him on the ice.
Another good one.
Nice job, Layden. You're a little fisherman. You got a crappie.
Is it a keeper? No, it doesn't.
No, I think that one's going to be a little short. Some crappie here. So one little nice thing when you're fishing with kids especially is using a little swivel there to keep everything from getting twisted and tangled. But the little Invisi-swivels here work really well. They're neutral buoyant, so they don't kind of affect how the jig or the bobber acts, and you don't have to adjust the weights for the certain bobbers you're using and whatnot, so it works real well.
Here you go.
I got another one!
He's never going to salmon fish again.
There we go.
I got another one!
Lay it in. Leave it in the water. Oh, that's swimming, okay. Emeline. That's a fish on there. There you go.
Ah!
If you have questions about crappie or kokanee fishing in Southwest Washington, or if you'd like to fish with Cameron, just give him a call.
Episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that this show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.